Yeah, we see Mr. Brevet pass away. It's a weird situation. For those of you trying to figure out what we're talking about, the original bass player for the band named the Scatterlite. But it's a weird thing because him in a 80-year-old sick, but you know him a go move because you know him foreign and thing, him live. Him come out you know a check. The jury were people, them decided they were give him a award, him couldn't go, so him send him son go take the award. I go home back and them shoot him son, kill him. That right away put him in another level. You know, him did up at St. Andrew Hospital and him just dead. I mean, after hearing all of that, who wouldn't dead? You know, because you know, one of the biggest band them ever come out of Jamaica. That's the first thing where a rhythm where take over the world in terms of how much different nations have played this rhythm called ska. Bass player style as an upright bass him usually play to, you know. Yes, if I remember seeing them a couple of times, the upright bass. But can you imagine you're there foreign and you come home, you're there yard, you say you get an award after so much years, 50 odd years in the music. And then you send your son go feed. Only if you come now, come here, say your son get shot. Him take it to heart. Him take it to heart. So we want to say, yeah, bass player. Right on. Scatterlite still live. You have a whole heap of ska band in the world because of the Scatterlites. Man like Tommy McCook, Dizzy, Johnny Moore, Roland Alfonso. You know, the list goes on. I am told in the past issue that PJ Patterson was one of the manager who used to manage Scatterlite, but it weird because we are say the foundation of the music it get wiped out to the extent now where a music come now and dominate the whole scene in a Jamaica, but it not carry go nowhere more than in a Jamaica, because what happened now is that the amount of interview I do where people from all over the place are call me and ask me and I say, why Jamaica is a disappointment when come on to musically carrying the people them on a high, you know, and then just boof and let them go. Based off of the changing tides of the music. And everybody keep talking about it. But guess what? Nobody can do nothing about it. Because the youth, their mind, the youth, them headspace, they're not living in nowhere. You can't tell them about that. Because at this moment in time, is that them I deal with. And it's very difficult. It's very difficult for a man, you tell a man about another space, and him in this space, and him can't function in another space, and you can't say that space there is a good space. Even if the space had the damage to the totality, the sum total of the thing, it's like you have a little rat in a pumpkin or something, and you make the rat there, and the rat, not the RAT, the rat, it get rotten. Instead of you cut it out, you make it stay there and it just keep there. You know, them say one bad apple spoil the whole bunch. Yeah, one bad apple in a pack, the whole height spoil because of that one apple there. So we have to say the music feed the people them and the world. And when we say feed them now, we are talking about spiritually feed them, emotionally feed them. And we see the ska music go out there. And now we see more ska band outside of Jamaica than in Jamaica. You hardly have any ska band in Jamaica because nobody now put no ska music on them show. You understand? It have to be dancehall. Dominate the music. This the show them. Dancehall have to dominate because that is what is happening now. And that is how it go. What is happening now is what is happening. And most of the show them, the man keep a show him where I make money, so him no business. Him just put down certain things on the show. Yet they have certain people who keep true, and when them keep true, it pay off for them. So it's not true when a man say, "Why you have to change your vibes for succeed?" Because we see a whole heap of one never did change them vibes and succeed. Yet we see a whole heap of one change them vibes and succeed also. You know, because a whole heap of one tell us why. Them used to do cultural. I mean, I talk about the youth a while ago now. Just generally. I hope I want to tell you, boy, them used to do a whole cultural music and from the switch and Ghana, the Nats, and it's boom, them get big. So, we live in a society where it tell you, say, if you try to uplift yourself by uplifting others, it never work. So, yeah, what you have to do now? You have to uplift yourself and carry down everybody else. Yeah, because that it I say. Because if you uplift yourself in terms of socially, economically, and spiritually, hoping that others would be only uplifted. And when you turn around, you see, boy, you not get uplifted. So you just switch around and start to uplift yourself and then just to hell with the others. So a whole heap of artists get themselves involved in that. And we see, say, oh, it don't last no long, long time, really. And it not only, it may uplift you in terms of value, materialistically, but you want something where, all when you're gone, man, I mean, Bamal dead 30 years ago, Rasta. And you play Bob Marley song, the man it not come like oldies. Bob Marley is Bob Marley a sell paraphernalia a sell more than Michael Jackson and Elvis Presley put together. The two most popular face pan t-shirt is Che Guevara and Bob Marley out there. The two most popular face is Che Guevara and Bob Marley. And if you read the life story of Che during the times when him a fight with Castro and Mandy, you realize, struggle. And if you look on the music, and you look out there now, after how much years of Scatterlights done with it, I mean, them still in that tour still, but when you look on 50 years ago, I mean, 50 years ago, me a little picnic rasta. Me a glad hear the tune them, I don't know his way I go on. Me a run up and down on a Ray Town and Maiden Lane and Rosemary Lane. I hear all them tune and I go to Beaumont Beach, Beaumont Club, go watch them and all them way there. And me don't know his way I go on. All this, me just hear this music. 50 odd years after, people who never born 50 years ago, take the music and making money out of it. And having people dance to it. I am told that there's over 300 odd ska band in America. That's what I'm told. That there's over 300 ska band where I play ska. Can you imagine that? After 50 odd years, you have music from Jamaica where I feed a generation of youth who never born when the Scatterlights them was big. Dan Drummond, Roland Alfonso, Tommy McCook. I mean, I want to understand, say, there's certain things that feed a generation, and there's certain things that just feed your dog or your yard and stop the sound. And look you know, reggae come after ska, rock steady, dub music, reggae. Reggae come and I feed so much people. And when I talk about the feeding now, materially, we are talking about the feeding mentally, emotionally, and spiritually. And the music out there, the biggest music concert them between May, June, July, August, September in the world is featuring some Jamaican artists that do reggae. How that possible? That for years, many Jamaican artists leave Jamaica and journey thousands of miles away from them home to play this music from them homeland. That thousands of people outside of them homeland is listening to it and echoing it. And doing it over and over and over again in different styles and fashions and shape. So the longevity is very important to the minds and the consciousness of the ones them who come after. Because me remember when me I listened to the Scatterlights. Me remember quite well when me I listened to the Scatterlights. As a little youth, as me I say, run up and down the place. And it never resonated to me at all more than just a next music. And 50 years after me comes, how important the music is. That the man them who did a play it from them heart. Now we see some youth come. And I played from them pocket. And granted, a whole heap of man make money off of him dancehall vibes and him dancehall vibes. But you see, it's an ego thing I go on because after you damage a generation of people, you damage with this way of articulating craziness and madness and thing, and you know, check it. Yeah, wait till you reach now, like I'll 40, I'll go 50 now, then you start to say, boy, right now, boy, me can't bother with them things again, you know, because, you know, me have to watch all my pick them now, and then, but look how much people you done corrupt already. Look how much people you done incite. Look how much people did listen to what you say and act it out. And them behavior is repugnant. Because whole heap of ones now, whole heap of youth, let me see now. I mean, like, the mannerism. Just the way them behave and react, Rasta. It make you feel like, you know, everyone, you just want to lock up and nobody deal with them like a youth, you know, because they might get you vexed. And you know, I tell them to go out like no Englishman need, I know. But you tell them, say, just be a normal here. You know, what I mean? It's weird. There was a time when the music take a tie in a rude boy level, and the rude boy got a jail, and rude get bail, and rude this and rude that. And a man just say, well, enough. No, we can't work with that, you know. Because situation we are going on and this and this and that. But man change and man see the change and work it out. Now we see everybody there on the same level. it's sad because a pure toilet paper music I make. Yeah, pure talent paper music I make, Rasta. I shouldn't say that, you know. I should take back my word. Most of the tune them, where we hear right now, on the earwaves, toilet paper. It's very difficult for a man like the pan reader now as a disc jack and him come in with all a dozen CD. You get a dozen CD today. And the next week you come and get another dozen. And it's like you want to play a tune 4 or 5 times, but the other thing I go, you know, it's like the same artist I make all 7, 8 tune for the week. And then I bring the same, bring the TDM come give you, I don't even know which one to play. So there's a level of tile paperism where I go on, where you just make the music today and you just use it and wipe yourself and dump it and wait for the next one to come, because it have no longevity, it not keep on. It not keep on. Most of the music that we are make now, it not go on. It not continue. Most of them. And me I say most of them, because me I hear most of them. And me I realize, next year you not hear them. This year you not hear them. I mean, 1 month after you not hear them. As a matter of fact, an artist feels, an artist get insecure in Jamaica right now if him not hear himself on the radio every day. So when him carry a music, go get a disc jack, and the disc jack play 2 times, him a think, say, boy, him get a ear play, but next week, him have to make another tune, because I want the kind of steal, because I'm here 2 times on the radio, him don't want to hear that again. And then him train up the listener, for thinking of that kind of mannerism to him, train up the listener, listen to him, and say, so you got a new tune. And 2 weeks ago, I met the tune, and I said, you have a new tune. This jacker asked him to, you know, a new tune. You know, at 3 times, I play that tune upon the radio, you know, and then a new tune. So, I have to follow, like, going at the, and every day, I'm in the studio, I stand up and I make music. And them now reach nowhere. A man just play that 2 times and just dump that. And him now go back for that. The only way him go back for that is if police shoot you, or you meet in some brawl where you shoot a man, or some criminal thing, your man say, wait, but I have a tune with him, I have him time, now I'm going to play it. And then the people them over the other side of the world know, I said, so, oh, Jamaica get so, just a while ago, a man sent me a text, just a while ago, a youth from France sent me a text and asked me about the music now. Because him disappointed. Because his reggae music bring him come here. Reggae music bring him come here. And him did not expect something other than where him say. Maybe it's like the youth there a while ago. You know, it's like, wow. Oh, we get that way there. And yet still right now, as we speak, there's so much festivals are going in the world, in Europe, go right down to August, where reggae music will take center stage. I mean, I talk about reggae music. A reggae music, I talk about, you know. So going back to all my brethren now, Ninja. When Ninja Man say, reggae dance all dead. Him himself now go look back pan film way of doing the thing and say, wait, I wonder if me did help do it. Kill it. I wonder, who kill reggae and dance all? Who kill it? You can't blame politician. Can't blame politician another one, yeah. So who really kill the music? Somebody did it. And we know, say, the kind of music we see come out by certain artists, is that cause it? But what? We still embrace it. DJ still played on the radio. You go dance, you hear it said we, and nobody now check the consequence of that action by keep playing it, because it just come like a nice thing at the time, just like when you're there toilet and you're done and you take the toilet paper, it's a nice thing, it just feel good, you know, whoops, I oh God, but you flush that and it's done with it. Next. It's a terrible thing. It's a terrible thing. Ninja Man say, dancehall, reggae dancehall dead. I contend that Ninja Man is one of the man them who helped to kill it. This is the cutting edge on IRFM.